Boxing Eagle here. If you like this video, make sure you hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon on the top of your screen to get notified when the latest new content drops. One. Canelo Alvarez, win or lose versus Golovkin in the rematch, set to face Irish fighter Gary Spike O'Sullivan. Stay tuned. What up, fight world? It's your boy Ego, and I'm back with some more boxing. Make sure you smash the like button. Also, subscribe to the channel for the latest and greatest in boxing. If you want to become part of the gang, notification gang, please hit the bell icon. Shout out to the Super Chat channel donations, the Venmo donations, and the Patreon family. We working. Now, shout out to worldboxingnews.net. Link is in the description. Interesting interview that they conducted with Gary Spike O'Sullivan. You guys may have seen him on the Billy Joe Saunders versus David Lemieux HBO card. That's the last fight I've seen him with. He also fought Billy Joe Saunders in the past and lost to BJS, right? Sullivan beat Antoine Douglas on that card. And he did an interview with World Boxing News, and he says he's next in line to fight Canelo in September. He also gave his prediction. He says, I quote, "I believe Billy Joe Saunders would beat Canelo and Golovkin too, probably 9 out of 10 times. He's a special fighter. He can beat both of them. If I was going to the bookmakers and I got given 10 grand and the only way I would get it back is by predicting correctly, I would put it on Billy Joe Saunders," right? He also says that he's already set to fight Canelo in September, regardless of the outcome of the rematch in the Canelo Triple G 2. That's what he's claiming. He says, "I've discussed that with Billy Joe Saunders. He believes he's fighting Golovkin next, regardless of the results as well. He told me he's going to be ringside for my fight on May 4th, and we're going to go along and observe the action between Canelo and Triple G in the rematch together. He will be going for Golovkin, whereas I'll be rooting for Canelo because I'm going to be fighting Canelo, whereas Billy Joe will want Golovkin to win so he can unify the division. We'll be shouting for different fighters that night," he concluded. Link in the description. So, interesting news coming off of the Antoine Douglas match. Spike O'Sullivan said he's going to be on the card. The May 4th card. Initially, I heard they were thinking about putting him in there with David Lemieux, but it sounds like he's turned down that notion and said, win, lose, or draw, he's fighting Canelo in September. Now, my thoughts to this, I got to see who he's fighting on May 4th. I can't really comment on that until I see who he's fighting. It's not going to be David Lemieux. Is it going to be just a random name? You know what I mean? Somebody in the top 10? You know what I mean? So I got to reserve my comments until I see who Spike O'Sullivan would be facing. Looks to be a pretty solid fighter. He already lost to Billy Joe Saunders, so is he ready for world level? I mean, that's going to determine if they put him in there with someone good. But, like, it's kind of weird if he... The Antoine Douglas win was cool, but Curtis had already done that and knocked him out, right? So if they don't... If they match him super soft, then that's going to be kind of a hard sell, like, where you're just... putting Spike O'Sullivan in there with Canelo to, like, off of a bad win, or not even, I can't say bad win, but a no-name win. So hopefully they give him a name that we all recognize for Spike O'Sullivan. But like I keep screaming, new media, Boxing Ego, at the end of the day, who's looking right and who's looking wrong more often than not? I told you guys, guys like Daniel Jacobs, Jermall Charlo are going to have a tough time because they are tall for the division. They have big in terms of frame wise. They have power, athletic ability. Charlo has a very good jab. Jacobs has a lot of pro level and amateur experience. He mixes his punches up well, can use his feet if need be. Different things. Switch southpaw if he wants, right? And this sounds about right, to be honest. Canelo, I mean, if he loses, him versus Spike is whatever. But according to Spike O'Sullivan, if Canelo beats Golovkin, instead of facing Billy Joe Saunders, they would match him in with Spike O'Sullivan, who again is not a bad fighter, but he lost to Billy Joe Saunders. Or bigger fights like Canelo versus Jermall Charlo, who he could have fought at 54, now has the opportunity to fight at 160, or Daniel Jacobs. You know what I mean? So this seems right. Win, lose, or draw, Canelo fighting Spike O'Sullivan. Again, he's a solid fighter, but I got to see a little bit more because he did lose to Billy Joe Saunders and beating Antoine Douglas. Douglas, to be honest, not making any excuses, taking away from O'Sullivan's performance, but he has not looked the same since he took that first L, that first pro L to Antoine when Antoine Douglas lost to Curtice, to be honest. So it's just amazing how he's claiming, which again, to me, sounds like a move the Golden Boy would do, because Canelo is their last remaining chess piece, big star, that's already ready built. You know what I mean? They got some people like Ryan Garcia who they're trying to build, but Ryan Garcia, that's my dude. Shout out to him. Shout out to Victorville. He hasn't fought the level of competition that'll catapult him to stardom as of right now. So Canelo's the only ready-made established star. So I can understand him. Now, some people would argue that Canelo coming off two potential tough fights with Gennady Golovkin and Chavez Jr. before that, Canelo deserves a softer touch instead of jumping right in for a Daniel Jacobs or Jermall Charlo if they win their next fights. But I kind of expected this move from Golden Boy to take a guy like, even if he doesn't have a big name, even if it's not a bigger fight, but a fight where they can extend the gravy chain, or especially if Canelo's coming off a loss. I mean, that just changes everything different. If Golovkin beats him, then that's really justified for him to fight Spike O'Sullivan. But if he wins, it seems like you would go after Billy Joe Saunders at least, or Jacobs or Charlo, because those are bigger fights and they mean more for the division, and or they'll get you to undisputed since you patch it up with the WBC. If you beat Golovkin, Canelo will have all the belts. So I got to see more from Spike O'Sullivan. He seems pretty solid, but I haven't seen him beat anyone really in prime world level type of people to the point. But once again, it looks like they're using Canelo's star power as a marketing, like they did with Liam Smith. Nobody was really begging for the Liam Smith. They would have rather see Demetrius Andre, the Charlo brothers, or somebody like that get the fight. But in the end, or Kell Brook even, in the end, Golden Boy still matched Canelo with Liam Smith. Just use it, you know what I mean? Just put it in the right area in Texas where they knew a high Hispanic dense population of people live. It would come just to see the opportunity to see Canelo fight. You know what I mean? But I can't say I'm shocked by this news. I could definitely see Golden Boy making the Spike O'Sullivan. That's what he's claiming. We'll see if anyone comes out and refutes what he's claiming as far as the fight is done, win, lose, or draw. This kind of news, just hearing that there's already a plan whether he wins or loses, and it's not a plan to be undisputed, it kind of makes me want Golovkin to win, especially with the whole, like, the asterisks or the cloudiness by the clenbuterol situation. You know what I mean? It kind of makes me want Golovkin to win just for the sake of boxing, just in the sense that if Golovkin wins, he's not guaranteed to fight Spike O'Sullivan. You know what I mean? He probably would go after Billy Joe Saunders. That's what even Spike O'Sullivan is saying. So, you know what I mean? Kind of makes you pull for Golovkin, because at least he'll probably, if he's not going to give Jacobs a rematch or fight Charlo his mandatory, then most likely what he'll be doing is trying to unify and become undisputed with Billy Joe Saunders. Just my thoughts. Let me know what you guys think. Canelo allegedly has a deal with Spike O'Sullivan. He's looking mean in camp for Golovkin. The clenbuterol situation came up. Like I said, I'm tired of talking about it. It's a bunch of speculation. Not in the fact that he failed two drug tests. That's a fact. But the reason behind it is all finger pointing and speculation. No one outside of the inner circle really knows what went on. You could go, oh, it's a picogram and all this stuff, but you don't really know if he's guilty. It just looks suspicious. You know what I mean? You don't know if he's innocent. You don't know if he's guilty. So I'm getting tired of it, and I don't think it's going to prevent the fight from happening. Let me know what you guys think of Canelo versus Spike O'Sullivan. Drop your thoughts in the comment section. Make sure you smash the like button as always. Hey, comment and subscribe to the next video's Egos. So if you enjoyed this video and want more content like this on the channel, you can show your appreciation by going to the PayPal donate button or the YouTube support button. And you can donate any amount that you feel is equivalent to the value of this video. Much more to come. Thank you guys for your support. Boxing Ego, the future of boxing.